you're right.
Chicago! People of the world! I wish you could see what I'm seeing right now. Flags of all colors and people of all walks of life stand before me. I am overwhelmed and amazed and hopeful for a better future because you are a part of history in the making right now. Take a look at who's standing next to you and remember their face on this day. This day is history. To all the participants of this rally, thank you. To all the veterans who stand against the war, and to all war machine resistors, thank you. On behalf of Afghans all over the world, thank you. And to the dispatchers and journalists and correspondents, you have walked with us all along the way from the beginning in this march. You are a part of this history. You are recording everything for the world to see, those who are not here. Thank you. My name is Saba Meher, and I am a daughter of refugees. I have never seen my ancestral lands, but I will address you all, dispatchers. I will address you all to bring the Afghan voice here today. To all dispatchers, before I offer you my reaction to the midnight raid and slaughter of my brothers and sisters in Afghanistan by a reported all too drunk and overstressed soldier, I ask you, what is good enough for a massacred people? They say, let us use pilgrimages to Hajj as a front for reparations. To all dispatchers, what is good enough for you, your family, or my family? Afghan good enough. When the occupying forces do not even know our Afghan names, a name for us, the one entitled to decree what is good enough for an Afghan other than the Afghan. Mr. and Mrs. Dispatcher, excuse me for my lack of sympathy, but an apology just won't do because my fingertips trace rusted circles around nothing endlessly, and I wonder where these traces will take me. Where will they take me? I wonder if this is the way it's supposed to be. To trace nothing but blood while wishing away hopelessly. While wishing away hopelessly. Tell me, you wanna understand? You wanna understand how 1,000 times over isn't enough? 30 more years of ripping skin? Decades of choked pain that drains the color from the flesh, that torments the mind and eats through the nerves. Do you want to understand how it feels when your mother is raped with bullets and your father's every cell locked in steel? Do you? Huh? Do you? How every dream for peace and return is slapped with the reality of Brandenburg? How every morning prayer is split into 77 consecutive funerals in my mana, but not before every corpse is dragged on the back of a bunker of a pickup truck to the governor of Kandahar, because Bunker Buster Boss beheaded the orphans in Nangarhar, because the drill of rocket attacks launched from Bagram left a permanent drum in Aryana's bleeding ear, and she can't fall asleep at night without the low of a tomcat's drone. She can't make it in the day if her cries aren't met with roadside roar. You wanna know, do you, that even the wind has a color in Afghanistan? The color of soot-covered rose, the color of soot-covered rose. Because the earth has no stomach to house casualties of war. We are not ghosts. We are not ghosts. Our flesh will return to the earth to remind you of our mortality. She will spit back every martyred man, woman, and baby to join us in an undying army commanded to sing, live, resist, dance, chant, breathe, attempt, exist, and love you! Yes, we will love you! Even when 1,600 pound bombs are deployed to break our backs, we will love you! Even when you insult us by desecrating our dead, we will love you! We will love my tax dollar funded green, blue, brown, hazel, foreign eyed, occupied, khaki camo, invading, extraterritorial, ultra element, gung ho, war mongering, Bible muttering, Afghan blood on your hands, US NATO led and lost soldier. We will love you! Because Because love, not hatred, is the irrepressible spring that outlasts occupation. Wanna understand? Go ahead, raid villages and execute unborn children. Smash skulls and drifting doves, the wind ripples and blood, I smell the putrid stench of the NATO's calculated worth. When a mother screams to her death before giving birth, calculate that worth while her husband convulsively moans as she bleeds, drones drowning dreams. How you wanna understand, do you, Mr. and Mrs. Dispatcher? We are living, breathing dead bodies. No war machine's pre-calculated executions will carpet bomb us into submission. The U.S. and NATO war of liberation is no more liberated than our death is no more liberated than our last breath. We respectfully ask all of you to bow your heads in a moment of silence for 1 minute.